असे तुमा सद्गमय तमसोमा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्युर्मामृतंगमय। अर्थात हे प्रभु, आप हमें असत से सत की ओर ले जाएं, आप हमें तमस से ज्योति प्रदान करें, तथा हे प्रभु आप हमें मृत्यु से अमृतत्व प्राप्त कराएं।
From ignorance to knowledge, from darkness to light, this is what we always endeavor to follow, trying to find a little hope for things yet to come in such dark and difficult times keeps most of us going. We all face difficulties, be it grieving over loss of a loved one, waiting for it to be safe enough to venture out, or just being unable to meet our friends. Yet, despite these tough times, we remain hopeful for the future. A very good morning to Honorable Principal Ma'am, respected teachers, and my dear friends. I, Tanishka Singh, welcome you all to today's assembly presented by Class 9C on the topic, The Darkest Hour is Just Before the Dawn. Let's start the assembly by invoking the blessings of the Almighty through the morning prayer by Utkarsh.
Please join your hands and close your eyes. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same way with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger. Thanks be to God.
Despite the darkness that surrounds us, we must learn to see the light at the end of the tunnel. It is not only me who believes in this, but also my friend Kashvi, who will share her thoughts through a Hindi poem.
धन्यवाद तनिष्का, आज मैं इस विशेष अवसर पर कवि हर्षवर्धन प्रकाश द्वारा रचित कविता हो तिमिर कितना भी गहरा प्रस्तुत करना चाहती हूँ। यह कविता मुझे हर बार प्रोत्साहित करती है और आशा दिलाती है कि यह कठिनाइयों भरा समय भी बीत जाएगा। हो तिमिर कितना भी गहरा, हो रोशनी पर लाख पहरा, सूर्य को उगना पड़ेगा, फूल को खिलना पड़ेगा। हो समय कितना भी भारी, हमने ना उम्मीद हारी, दर्द को झुकना पड़ेगा, रंज को रुकना पड़ेगा। सब थके हैं, सब अकेले, लेकिन फिर आएंगे मेले, साथ ही लड़ना पड़ेगा, साथ ही चलना पड़ेगा। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू काशवी फॉर शेयरिंग सच अ वंडरफुल पोएम। सानवी, अ प्रोलिफिक राइटर फ्रॉम आवर क्लास, हैज रिटन अ फ्यू इंस्पायरिंग लाइंस। विल यू शेयर देम विद ऑल ऑफ अस?
Sure, Tanishka, it would be a pleasure. The future is indistinct, so many ways to bend it. The past may have shattered me, but what comes next will mend it. These lines match perfectly with the inspirational stories of our great Indians, which Ishan Srivastav is going to share. Best of luck, Ishan.
Thank you, Sanvi. I shall take it up now. Not everyone falls into success with their first try. In fact, very few of us do. Life for most people is a journey of self-discovery, finding out who we are, what we are best at, and how we can make a difference in this world. While we were discussing the topic for the assembly, I came across the inspiring story of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar and couldn't resist myself from sharing it. I also had a glimpse of his one early life struggle and how he tackled that. Today, I proudly share it with all of you. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was born in a family where he was debarred from social interaction, the right to study, and even didn't have supply to drinkable water. This was not the only pebble in his shoe that he countered, but still, he believed in himself and fought for his rights and became one of the best scholars in India. He also lent a big part in writing our constitution. Another great example is Arunima Sinha. She lost her left leg while fighting some robbers, and the day her leg was amputated, she took a pledge that many would find even difficult to comprehend. Her objective from that day onwards was not simply to prove her proficiency with a prosthetic leg, but was also to conquer the Mount Everest. The sense of accomplishment was what brought back her fearlessness as well as made her a motivation for aspirants. She contacted Bachendri Pal in 2011 and signed up for training at a camp at Uttarkashi. She left no stones unturned and became the first ever female amputee to climb this feat. She didn't stop here. She went on to conquer every highest peak in all the seven continents And that is how she proved that the darkest stars are really just before the dawn. Anushka, I would like to know your views upon this.
Thanks, Ishan. Those were some great examples. But the list doesn't end here. There are thousands and thousands of people just like them who strive every day and continue chasing their dream, even if they face backlash in their early days. They only come out to become the most important source of inspiration when we tend to lose hope. Life is full of challenges and surprises. The difference lies in the way of our acceptance for both. Problems are inevitable. We can never get rid of them completely. And sometimes we cannot even change them. Obstacles are there, but they aren't permanent. Instead, they are temporary, just like everything on earth. It is important for us to cross these barriers with a good attitude and enthusiasm. As we go through challenges, we become stronger and stronger. When we overcome them, we develop emotional and mental strength. It is all about us and our mindset. If we train ourselves to look at everything in life with a positive attitude, we will find that life is not as bad as we think it is. Just like two of my friends, Ishanvi and Mayank, who faced such backlash but overcame it without altering their mental strength.
Thank you, Anushka. Now, I would like to share my experience with everyone. When I was 9 years old, I was diagnosed with a disease called bilateral genu-valgum, due to which the bone in my leg was getting skewed. I was asked to wear special shoes which I wore for 2 years, but in vain. The shoes were very heavy, but I had to wear them all the time, even at party. I felt ashamed and cried a lot because I did not want to wear them. However, I still had hope that I would be free from this disease very soon. After 2 years, when there had been no improvement, the doctor told us that the last resort was surgery. My mother and I cried for a whole day, but my father motivated us and found the best orthopedic surgeon. I traveled to Mumbai to meet him, and when he saw my reports, he said those magical words which I had been waiting to hear for years. The surgery eventually took place, for which none of us were scared at all, since we knew I was in the best hands. The surgeon was like an angel in disguise for us, because of whom today I am perfectly all right. It was a blessing to find a doctor who cured me totally, and this experience of mine has made me realize that if God closes one door, He always opens another door. Thank you.
I totally agree with you, Ishanvi. There is always a ray of hope even in the worst circumstances in life. I too has experienced such an incident in my life recently. This pandemic named COVID-19 has taken lives of many people. And I want to tell you that this infection struck my family also. It had infected my parents and my sister. My cousins and I were helping them throughout the day. We bought number of medicines, but at times the medicines were unavailable at shops. All associates of my family didn't lose hope despite the odds, which made them emotionally and mentally strong, making their recovery fast. Problems set everyone's life, but we must not lose hope. We will surely get out of the situation soon, as it won't last forever.
Ishanvi and Mayank, मैं आपका अनुभव भली भांति समझ सकती हूँ। आपकी ही तरह हर व्यक्ति के जीवन में ऐसे दुख, कष्ट एवं संघर्ष के क्षण आते हैं। परंतु जिस प्रकार हर अंधेरी रात के बाद दिन होता है, उसी प्रकार कठिनाइयों का समय भी निरंतर नहीं रहता। हम इस अनिश्चित समय में केवल आशा कर सकते हैं कि स्थितियां शीघ्र समान हो जाएं और हम इस कोविड विभीषिका को हराकर विजयी हों।
Absolutely right, Kashmi. And we are all well aware of the situation wherein, on one hand, people across India and around the globe are largely confined to their homes, while on the other hand are the doctors, healthcare members, and other people making our lives easier by putting their own lives, health, and families at risk with selfless determination for the sake of saving lives. They are truly our heroes in these challenging times. I would now request everyone to close their eyes and observe a minute of silence as a tribute to the COVID warriors.
When you face challenges, know that they are not to destroy you. They are sent to promote, increase, and strengthen you. Life is full of challenges, but these challenges are given only to you because God knows that your faith is strong enough to get through them. I am Janvi Rai, and now I'll be sharing a small video clip playing the song We Shall Overcome. I strongly believe that it will stimulate you to overcome your challenges.
It was great of you all to share your thoughts and experiences with us. I would like to invite Archana Singh ma'am to say a few words.
धन्यवाद तनिष्का बेटा. जैसा कि अभी ईशान ने हमें बताया, डॉक्टर भीमराव अंबेडकर और अरुणिमा सिन्हा सच में ये महान व्यक्तित्व हैं. हमें इनसे प्रेरणा मिलती है और प्रेरणा लेनी चाहिए. लेकिन आज मुझे दो ऐसे लोगों के बारे में भी पता चला कि असली प्रेरणा तो हमें उनसे लेनी चाहिए. सच में ईशानवी बेटा और मयंक बेटा, आपने सच में बहुत हिम्मत और हौसले से काम लिया. ये सच में काबिले तारीफ है और इसी वजह से आज आप सफल हो, स्वस्थ हो और हम सभी के लिए प्रेरणा के स्रोत भी. हम सभी को आपसे प्रेरणा मिलती है बेटा. चलिए अब विषय पे आते हैं. रोशनी से पहले घना अंधेरा होता है. सच में अगर घना अंधेरा नहीं होगा तो रोशनी को पूछेगा कौन, रोशनी की कीमत कौन समझेगा, उसका महत्व कौन जानेगा. उम्मीद रोशनी की सदा जिंदा रखो. एक किरण छिपी है इन्हीं अंधेरों में कहीं, उसे देखने की उम्मीद सदा जिंदा रखो. तो उम्मीद जिंदा रहेगी, रोशनी की किरण अवश्य मिलेगी. हमें निराश और हताश नहीं होना है. कहते हैं जब एक जलता हुआ दिया बुझने की कगार पे पहुंचता है, बुझने वाला होता है ना, तो वो और तेजी से फड़कने लगता है. ये इस बात का संकेत देता है कि अब उस दिए के बाद कोई भी, जैसे कोई कष्ट आने वाला होता है तो बहुत तेजी से अपना प्रभाव दिखाने लगता है. उसी प्रकार उस समय घना अंधकार होता है, इसका मतलब है उसके पीछे छिपी हुई रोशनी जल्दी ही हमारे सामने आने वाली है. ये इस बात का संकेत होता है. हम सबने देखा होगा कि जब बारिश होती है तो बारिश से पहले बदली छा जाती है. धीमे 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 जो है अंधकार होना शुरू होता है और एक समय आता है जब घना अंधेरा छा जाता है. उस घने अंधेरे में आप इमेजिन करके देखिए, सोच कर देखिए कि उस घने अंधेरे में जब एक बिजली चमक जाती है तो हमें सारी चीजें कितनी साफ और स्पष्ट दिखाई देने लगती है. तो तब उस अंधेरे में उस बिजली की जो कीमत होती है, उस बिजली की कीमत तभी पता चलती है जब अंधेरा होता है. अगर हल्का सा प्रकाश हो उसमें अगर कभी बिजली तब भी चमकती है जब हल्की बारिश हो रही होती है, तो तब उसकी कीमत हम उतनी अच्छे से नहीं समझ पाते जितनी हम इस स्थिति में समझ पाते हैं. सच में ये जो क्षणिक सुख होता है ना, क्षणिक एक आभास होता है ना, वो ज्यादा सुख देने वाला होता है, ज्यादा आत्मीयता से भरा होता है और ज्यादा हमें प्रसन्नता भी देता है. इसी तरीके से जो प्रकृति है, वो प्रकृति भी हमें बहुत सारे संकेत देती है और प्रकृति हमें बहुत सारे संदेश भी देती है. जैसे नदी होती है ना, तो जब उसमें अथाह जलराश भरी होती है, उससे पहले, उसके ठीक पहले नदी एकदम सूखी होती है, नहर की तरह एक पतली सी जलधारा होती है. नदी का अधिकांश भाग रेत के समान होता है और वह रेत अपना प्रभाव पूरे तरीके से जमाए रहती है जब तक नदी में अथाह जलराश नहीं आ जाती. तो ये भी इसी बात का संकेत है कि सुख आने से पहले, सुबह आने से पहले अधिक कष्ट का अनुभव करना पड़ता है. ऐसे ही हम एक वृक्ष का भी उदाहरण ले सकते हैं कि वृक्ष जो है हरा भरा लदा पेड़ एकदम खड़ा है, फल है, पत्तियां हैं, फूल है, एक समय आता है पतझड़, पूरा पेड़ जो है वो नग्न हो जाता है, एक भी पत्ते नहीं बचते, बचता है केवल तना और डाले. लेकिन उस पतझड़ से अगर हम निराश हो गए ना, तो फिर कुछ नहीं मिलने वाला है. हमें इंतजार करना होता है बसंत का, अर्थात उस रोशनी का जिसकी हमें चाह है। और बसंत में क्या होता है सबको पता है, नए नए कपड़े मिलते हैं सभी पेड़ छोटे छोटे पौधों को वृक्षों को, ठीक नए नए कोंपल आते हैं और पेड़ों की सुंदरता 100 गुना बढ़ जाती है। तो इससे हमें क्या समझ आता है कि किसी भी स्थिति में हमें निराश नहीं होना है, हमें हताश नहीं होना है। कहते हैं, किसी ने कहा है, बहुत सुंदर दो लाइनें हैं कि कीमत रोशनी की तभी समझ आएगी जब कभी एक रात अंधेरी कोठरी में बिताई होगी। जिसने कभी अंधेरा नहीं देखा वो रोशनी क्या जाने। इसलिए रोशनी का स्वागत करने के लिए, उसका महत्व समझने के लिए हम सभी को घने अंधकार से भी गुजरना पड़ेगा। तो उस अंधकार में हमें अपनी हिम्मत नहीं हारनी, अपना हौसला टूटने नहीं देना है और पूरा प्रयास करना है कि हम बहुत अच्छे से उसका सामना करें और हमारा व्यक्तित्व और निखर कर और चमक कर नए कोपल के समान, अथाह जलराशि के समान सबके सामने आए और हम सबके लिए प्रेरणा के स्रोत बने। तो इससे हमें यही सीख मिलती है कि जब भी कभी जीवन में निराशा आए, दुख के बादल घनघोर छा रहे हों, तो समझ जाइए कि अब हमारे दुखों का अंत होने वाला है। ये संकेत है कि अच्छे दिन आने वाले हैं। आप सभी का दिन शुभ हो। धन्यवाद।
थैंक्स अ लॉट मैम, योर वर्ड्स हैव रियली टच्ड आवर हार्ट्स। I would now like to call upon Chinmay for the last shlok.
Om Purnamidah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnyameva Vashishyate. Om Shantihi Shantihi Shantihi.
I request Principal Ma'am to enlighten us with her thoughts.
Good morning, teachers and children. Very well presented assembly. All those children who were there in the assembly, just tell me, anyone of you can answer, what did you learn from today's assembly? I'm not talking of the content, but while preparing for the assembly, what did you learn? How did you feel? Okay, how did you feel while preparing for the assembly?
Ma'am, if I speak about myself, then maybe if I'm speaking something wrong, but what I felt was, I am fulfilling Gita's Gita's aim. This is what this life felt. And that's
it. Thank you. So every word of Gita is actually yogic. Right, Krinali? You know Gita a lot, much, much more than I know. So, and you have been into that yogic state, right? While fulfilling your purpose in life. All right. Thank you, Krinali. Yes. Anyone else? Sanvi, Tanishka? You conducted the assembly beautifully, Tanishka, and all those children who gave their personal examples as well.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, ma'am, we also got to know a lot about each other. Like, it was a bonding experience for the class itself, since online we're not meeting as much.
And you came to know about these two children, what they were going through. Yes. All right? So you learned about each other. Now, when you learned about them, how did you feel? What is the feeling that you felt should be there in you?
I felt empathic, like I've been meeting them each day and I didn't know that they've been through the stage.
True. So when you read about empathy, it's different. But when you are associated with someone who's gone through something, that feeling of empathy, does it become something that should be there lifelong in you or not?
Yes.
Right? You start feeling that. Now the two children who shared their experience, can you speak? You went through a tough time. So who's that boy? Prakhar, I think, right? He spoke about his family suffering from COVID. Mayank.
Okay. Yes.
So Mayank, when you were going through, you know, this pain and you were taking care of the family, what did you learn?
Ma'am, that there is always a line of hope even in the worst circumstances, even in the worst situation in our life. There is always a ray of hope.
Yeah, there is always a ray of hope. But for that, but to catch that, you have to do what?
Ma'am, we should not lose our confidence, ma'am, so that we can raise our confidence level so that it can create a situation that, yeah, something could be happen now also.
Right. Did you make any, so to put things in place in your house, what all did you do?
Ma'am, I bought a number of medicines, ma'am, my cousins and I were helping them throughout the day and there was not a good situation in my house, but yeah, we hold that situation in such a way that yeah, we could manage everything.
So the entire day, were you working towards it, buying medicines, then taking care of food, taking care of the parents?
Yes, ma'am. Only sometime I gave to studies, but yeah, helping them, my family.
The whole day you were busy. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And so you made a lot of effort.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. At the end of the day, what was your physical condition?
Ma'am, I was tired, ma'am. Like lying on bed and ma'am like that.
And sleep immediately. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
And what was your emotional condition? You can tell me, fearful, happy, or at the end of the day after looking at the reports.
I was happy every time, ma'am. Ma'am, I was happy of doing, helping my family for in that worst situation. Ma'am, I was happy like that. Ma'am, there was no sadness in my mind.
Yeah, so you kept on working. You were tired, but you felt happy because you were empathetic. You were making a lot of effort.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Did you feel you progressed anyway? Did you learn certain things while taking care of the family?
Yes, ma'am.
Hmm? Yes, have you become a little more calm after that?
Yes, ma'am.
Feeling more settled?
Ma'am, I was feeling calm that, yeah, I'm helping my family. I'm managing my own work also. So, ma'am, helping your family is a great work in life.
Yes. So, you felt less restless?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
In life, in, you know, people you know or around you or whenever you grow. So at that time in life, whenever such a situation arises that around you there are people who are suffering and you are supposed to take care, internally, what will you be? Will you be restless the way you were when you came to know about your parents and family suffering, or will you be more calm and handle the situation calmly?
No, ma'am, I will handle the situation, ma'am. They are also the person whom we know. They are also the people of the earth. They are also the human beings, so we should help them. Even if they are not in relation with us, but then also we should help them.
So all of you, while doing the assembly, you said you felt more empathetic. Rinali said that whatever is the aim, purpose of her life, she felt that she was achieving that purpose. She was truer to Gita. You became calmer. So all these experiences, whether it is assembly or taking care of the sick or going through that sickness, did they take you from ignorance to knowledge?
Yes, ma'am. Definitely.
Right? You moved from ignorance to knowledge. Yes, now, tell me, if you had not taken up this challenge, if you had not taken up the challenge of the assembly and felt lazy, no, Bhuna ma'am, I don't want to do it. I've got a lot of homework. I've got this. I've got that. Would you have understood these experiences, Tanisha?
No, ma'am.
Mayank?
No, ma'am.
Would you have been so empathetic, forever being more calm and offering everything to God?
Yes.
Every challenge. Okay, and who's that girl who had the surgery?
Ma'am, I.
Yeah.
Ma'am and teachers.
Good morning, beta. So that has been what? How did you behave with your doctors?
I was very scared, but they just consoled me and said that it is very common and you know this disease and many, and this is very common disease and many people don't know this. My relative told me that this is a disease. My mother thought that maybe because of something, and she said that she didn't knew this about this disease. And when she went to a doctor, then he said that now the age of the surgery has gone and you can't be back to normal stage.
Okay, so now you respect doctors a little more?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You trust them a little more?
Yes.
Even if there are all kinds of people around you. And you feel stronger even more or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you fearful of the hospital?
Yes, ma'am.
Now?
No, ma'am.
Not now. Earlier?
Yes, ma'am. I was earlier.
So you have moved from ignorance to knowledge. What I mean to say is, children, that everything that is happening around you is for a purpose. Take part in all those challenges. If they are around you, take the plunge so that you try to decode those challenges. And then each time you do that, you take yourself from ignorance to knowledge. That is what we mean by tamasoma.
Jyotir
Gamaya. And that is what we mean by conscious Transformation. Okay. All right. All the best. Thank you so much, Runa ma'am. Once again, it was lovely talking to you, children.